The Greater Yellowstone Ecosystem is the last remaining large, nearly intact ecosystem in the northern temperate zone of the Earth. Although the Greater Yellowstone Ecosystem is an informal designation, the currently accepted boundaries include approximately 20 million acres, an area roughly the size of South Carolina. It includes two national parks, parts of six national forests, and three states, Montana, Idaho, and Wyoming. At its center is Yellowstone National Park, the oldest national park in the United States. The ecosystem also includes Grand Teton National Park, parts of the Gallatin, Beaverhead Deer Lodge, Custer, Caribou Targhee, Richard Teton, and Shoshone National Forests, as well as the National Elk Refuge and Red Rock Lakes National Wildlife Refuge. The area is one of the world's foremost natural laboratories in landscape ecology and geology, and is a world-renowned recreational site. The Greater Yellowstone Ecosystem is home to a full suite of wildlife, including elk, moose, bison, and the large carnivores, most notably grizzly bears. It is one of only two large area grizzly bear populations in the lower 48 states. Within the Greater Yellowstone Ecosystem, grizzly bears range from valley bottoms to the tops of mountains, following a progression of food sources over the spring, summer, and fall in an effort to amass fat that allows the bears to sleep during the harsh winter months. At the tops of the mountains throughout the ecosystem, there is a unique forest community. Whitebark pine is the dominant tree species in the upper subalpine zone above 8,000 feet and plays an integral role in ecosystem function, impacting nutrient and water cycles, soil development, and snow and water retention that feed the area's streams and rivers. Northern flickers and mountain bluebirds often nest in whitebark pine, and elk and blue grouse use whitebark pine communities as summer habitat. The whitebark's large, protein-rich seeds are also an important food source for birds, squirrels, black and grizzly bears, and other mammals. The importance of whitebark pine seeds to the grizzly bear is of particular importance in the ecosystem due to scarcity of other high-quality food during the critical time prior to entering hibernation. Whitebark pine is at risk throughout its range due to the combined effects of climate change, white pine blister rust, and mountain pine beetle. Concern for the species is increasing as mortality becomes evident across the ecosystem and the potential effects of climate change are better understood. The introduced fungal disease, white pine blister rust, is an immediate and serious threat to whitebark pine and is causing heavy mortality in the species. Generally, blister rust spores germinate on the plant surface and grow into the pine through openings in the needles or through a wound. Once inside the pine needle, the fungus grows down to the twig and into the branch and ultimately to the main stem of the tree. The damage caused by the rust kills the cambium, causing a canker, which girdles the stem, preventing water and nutrients from passing through. If the canker forms on the main stem, it will cause top kill and often cause the tree to die. Whitebark pine is highly vulnerable to infection by blister rust, with only 1/4 of the population showing genetic resistance to it. The mountain pine beetle is a native insect that has co-evolved as an important ecological component of western forests. Its attacks on overmature pines allows for replacement of those trees by young, healthy trees. The beetles bore into the bark of the pine host and can cause the tree to die within a year or two. The colder climate associated with high elevation pines has generally been too extreme for mountain pine beetles to thrive, even though these pines are suitable hosts. Since 2000, studies have documented an alarming level of mountain pine beetle-caused mortality throughout the ecosystem's whitebark pine. The intensification of bark beetles within their historic range and expansion into high-elevation ecosystems over that time is of great concern. A combination of factors may be responsible for these attacks. However, more information and research is needed about mountain pine beetle ecology in high-elevation sites. Another contributing factor to the decline of whitebark pine has been the occurrence of large forest fires over the tree's range. Whitebark pine are not fire tolerant. Their bark is thin, and the trees and seed are easily killed by fire. There are substantial concerns that greenhouse gas-induced climate changes will impact high elevation areas. Conflicting predictions obscure certainty on what may occur. However, in all cases, elevational shifts in vegetative composition are expected. Many scenarios forecast a loss of native high-elevation subalpine forests. As other species disperse up the mountains, the current high-elevation species will eventually get squeezed off the mountaintops. Warming temperatures also result in increased mountain pine beetle activity at higher elevations where historically low temperatures prevented outbreaks. In 2000, a group of representatives from each of the federally managed areas included in the ecosystem came together to work toward maintaining and restoring the keystone role of whitebark pine in this special ecosystem. In 2011, the Greater Yellowstone Whitebark Pine Subcommittee released its comprehensive whitebark pine strategy for the Greater Yellowstone area. This strategy is intended to enable land management units to maximize the use of their limited resources to maintain the presence of whitebark pine in the ecosystem. This strategy includes documenting the current condition of whitebark pine, prioritizing areas for management action, providing techniques and guidelines to protect and restore whitebark pine, and promoting the understanding of the situation faced by whitebark pine. On the ground, this will mean crews performing surveys to inventory and monitor existing whitebark populations throughout the area. At the same time, the pheromone verbenone and the insecticide carbaryl will be administered to cone-producing trees and those exhibiting blister rust resistance to protect them from attack by the mountain pine beetle. Another strategy will involve protecting and collecting cones from healthy trees and the creation of a disease-resistant seed orchard. The seed orchard is currently being established on the Gallatin National Forest. The site will be an intensely managed 5-acre area where trees grafted in the nursery will be planted and will produce cones and seed that are resistant to blister rust. The strategy also aims to promote fire management policy that takes the whitebark pine into account. This will include protecting existing healthy trees and promoting whitebark reestablishment. In the long term, the primary restoration tool will be the planting of whitebark pine seedlings. The strategy prioritizes areas where whitebark pine seed sources have been reduced, in recently burned over whitebark pine stands, and in areas of heavy mortality from mountain pine beetle and or blister rust. The strategy helps to organize these efforts and promote interagency cooperation to help ensure the long-term viability and function of whitebark pine ecosystems in the Greater Yellowstone area. We hope the efforts we've completed and are planning are not too little, too late, given the immense pressure on whitebark pine communities. With current limitations of personnel and funding, the fate of whitebark pine in the Greater Yellowstone ecosystem remains uncertain.